We had only been in Cape Verde a few days. The airline or the boat company or both had misplaced our luggage. So what does a family do when this happens and you're on the other side of the world? We drink, we laugh, we eat, we drink some more. Their Superpock beer was amazing, and me and my brother soon became very big fans. We were definitely drinking our share. We had each other, though, and we had this beautiful island that our grandparents and mother and aunts and uncles grew up on, and we were immediately embraced by the people there. The music was amazing. The island was so rich in its culture. It seemed almost like everyone sang and played an instrument. A beautiful song was always on the lips of the people there. I looked around and I swear all of a sudden I felt like I was on my own favorite show, No Reservations. It was a dream come true.
Anthony Bourdain.
That's right.
I write, I travel, I eat, and I'm hungry for more.
With the promise of an amazing bakery, our favorite uncle was going to take us for a late night snack.
Superbach.
Same undies?
I've drunk Superbach 90% of my liquid since I've been here in the last 3 days.
That's been my meals.
Superbach.
Lean
not,
wagon
not
on?
Not by choice all the time, but right now by choice.
Superbach commercial, boom.
Cape Verde is dark and very, very quiet. We had had a few drinks. Vava was leading the way, but a left turn here, right turn here, it all sort of started to look the same.
What the fuck is that? Oh. That thing is huge. That's the size of my face.
So, we are in the islands of the Cape.
I was one turn away from generally losing my bearings on any idea of where we were and how we were going to get back to the house. But we wandered on with the promise of butter and a supposed bakery. And then we were there, the bakery. Not the one that we were expecting, but a bakery nonetheless.
That's what I want you guys to see.
Yeah. We entered the building directly into a small room that had a very big oven with a small copper door. The smell of dough was thick, the heat of the oven was welcoming. They had just started putting in their first batch. This bakery had been here a very long time. At one point, the building had burned down because of a fire in a nearby room, but after it was put out, the oven still stood. So they built the new house around the oven just as it was before. This beauty was seasoned with 50 plus years of wonderful baking inside it. All the boys working at the bakery were third and fourth generation bakers that had been involved in this process most of their lives. Their work was meticulous. Nothing was wasted. Everything was perfectly uniformed and they moved together in a silent dance of precise movements. That large slab of dough was suddenly being transformed into these perfectly matching round balls at an alarming rate. Everything done by hand with only the use of a cutter to separate smaller pieces from the large slab of dough. It was pretty late now, and again, we had had a few beers, maybe a little grog. My uncle seemed to think he was a Cape Verdean Mr. Miyagi, so of course some goofing around was going to ensue. The The boys took it like it was something of normalcy, never breaking stride and constantly working. They knew my uncle well, and he frequently stopped by on his way home late at night. The smell of the warm bread baking now started to spread through the room much stronger. We laughed and joked and patiently waited for them to be done. As the oven door was opened, the strong and wonderful smell of the fresh baked rolls hit our nostrils and we instantly salivated. With the tool as probably as old as the oven itself, the baker started to pull the bread out in wonderful bunches. The firm crust of the bread crackling together in unison into the waiting buckets. As I watched the bread cascade into the containers, my mind started to wander. All I could think was that this whole process had been done for such a long time in this exact spot. This baker's grandfather was the baker that supplied my grandparents and my mom and aunts and uncles with their daily bread. And here I was going to eat the same rolls my mother grew up on and tasted from the same oven that it was baked in when she was a child. It was a surreal moment for me. We waited with bated breath as we watched Baba cut the very hot bread in half and slather it with the butter we had brought with us. It really was a beautiful sight to see the butter melt into the soft nooks and crannies at the center of the roll. Finally, it was time to eat. My uncle, the genius. I loved him even more at this moment.
What's the kid doing?
He's first.
Yeah, his idea. Go ahead. We don't eat till he eats. Obrigado. I'm Tommy. Thank you. You know bread will never be right for you again, right?
That's why it's called fried bread, right?
Bread will never be the same.
Oh. Hey, Bourdain, no reservation here.
I don't know if I should keep chewing or what. Like, my mouth doesn't know what to do right now.
As we munched away on roll after buttered roll, the bakers kept working and turning out more and more. Literally thousands of rolls they would make for all of the island that night. A time-honored recipe and tradition passed down from father to son over generations and generations. It was an experience that I hope my son will have one day, knowing I stood right here and tasted perfection as well.
Sorry.